do, if you fix x, if you put x equal to 0, you'll get a equation of SHM or not? Okay, so let's talk about that as well. At a particular x, x equal to x naught, let's say, the equation will become what? A sine kx naught minus omega t plus phi. So I can write it at, like this, A sine minus omega t plus theta, or I can write it as minus of A sine omega t minus theta, right? Theta is what? Theta is my kx naught plus phi. So this looks like an equation of SHM, right? So wherever you go, at whatever x, you find that all the particles are performing SHM. Okay, fine. Now tell me, how will I find the velocity of the particle? I have found out the velocity of wave till now, okay? Velocity of wave is omega by k. This is what we have derived till now, and we have found out that all particles, they perform SHM along y-axis. Okay, now tell me, how will you find velocity of particle, vp? How will I get that? Huh, velocity of particle at a particular x, I am asking. So if I differentiate y, will I get velocity of particle? Is dy by dt velocity of particle or not? Right? Particle is moving in along y axis, so dy by dt, keeping x constant, because particle's velocity you will find at a particular x. This will be a minus of a omega cos of kx minus omega t plus phi. Getting it? Any doubt? No doubt? No. This is the velocity of particle as expected at a particular x. The velocity of particle is having the equation of the SHM. You can see that this you can write down as omega under root of a square minus a square sine square kx minus omega t plus phi, and this can be written as omega under root a square minus y square. So this is the velocity of particle, which looks exactly like the SHM equation. Okay, and where is the mean position at y equal to 0? For which particle? For all the particles. Now, just to tell you some relation, because it is not systematic, so it comes in bits and pieces that, okay, this is this, so do you know this, now this. So there is no connecting story as such, so that is why I have to move like that. So can you tell me what is the slope of the shape of the wave? So this is a wave, okay? So suppose at x comma t, I am trying to find out what is the slope of the wave. Are you getting? So basically dy by dx at a particular time is how much? This is equal to what? Slope. Slope of the shape of the wave at a particular x and t. Some of these things are not in your NCERT. Anybody got it? A k cos of kx minus omega t plus phi. Okay, so if I multiply and divide, the slope and velocity of particle is minus of a omega cos of kx minus omega t plus phi. So looking at these two equations, what comes to your mind? These two equations, what comes to your mind? Divide, get rid of sign, sorry, cos, these two gone. So velocity of particle divided by the slope is equal to minus omega by k. What is omega by k? Velocity of wave. So velocity of particle is the minus of velocity of wave into the slope at that location. Slope of the wave at that location. Okay. So this relation you can use probably for graphical questions. So at a particular location and at a particular time, if you have the shape of the wave, find out the slope of that wave at that location, multiply that slope with the velocity of wave, you'll get the magnitude of velocity of the particle.
So what is k here?
I'm coming to that. There is some significance of k and omega that we are going to discuss next. But right now, there are so many things. One by one we are discussing. So we have discussed velocity of wave. We have discussed that all particles perform SHM. Velocity of particle is dy by dt. And there is a relation between velocity of particle and velocity of wave. Okay? Now this is a wave. So if we are studying a wave, there will be something like frequency of wave and the wavelength of the wave. Right? Yes, A is the amplitude. You can see the wave equation here. A comes. Okay, A is the amplitude. Write down wavelength. Wavelength is represented by little lambda. Okay? What is the definition of wavelength? Anyone?
So it's the distance between any two equivalent. Difference in distance between any two points which have the same phase.
Okay, or distance between two crests or two troughs. Like that you have studied, right? So there are multiple crests and troughs. So which one you will take? Adjacent one. Okay, so please write down the shortest distance. The shortest distance between the two points in phase. The shortest distance between the two points in phase is the wavelength. Okay? What does it mean in phase?
They have the exact same wire.
We have just discussed what is phase. This is the phase. Yes or no? This inside this is phase. Now this phase repeats after what angle? There is a sine function. Sine repeats after 2 pi. So the phase will repeat after 2 pi. Right? So if two adjacent ones are some distance apart and they are in phase, they will be in terms of angle, they'll be at a distance of 2 pi. Because after 2 pi, phase repeats. So if phase repeats, now you can say that they are in phase. Okay? So let's say the particle 1 is this, A sine kx minus omega t plus phi. After, let's say, wavelength lambda, it comes out to be the same phase. So how will you write y2 as A sine of what?
Kx plus lambda.
Kx plus lambda minus omega t plus phi.
So, but the t is different, right?
No. How? I have frozen the wave at a particular time. I've taken a snapshot. You can't deal with wavelength of a moving wave. Look, by the time, let's say this is a wave. So, when you're measuring the distance between two crests, by the time you go from here to here, wave should not move. Okay. You should measure the distance at the same instant. Yes or no?
Yes.
I am saying that after lambda, same thing repeats. So if at x equal to x, this thing is happening, at x equal to x plus lambda also same thing will happen. Because after lambda, it is repeating, lambda is a wavelength. So instead of x, I am putting x plus lambda. Getting it? So this can be written as a sine of kx minus omega t plus phi plus k lambda. Got it? Now k lambda should be equal to what? 2 pi. Right? Because these two things are same. Y2 and Y1, if they have to be same, k lambda should be equal to 2 pi. Because after 2 pi, only sine will repeat itself. This thing is exactly same as that. This thing is extra. Adding up. If you add up minimum 2 pi here, same Y1 will come out. So that is the reason why k lambda should be equal to 2 pi. And from here, you're going to get lambda as
2 pi by k.
Write down.
So Y2 is? What's Y2?
Y1 and Y2 are the two points on the wave having the same phase. So this is, let's say, Y1, and this one is Y2. Y1 and Y2. Alright, so we have derived the wavelength to be 2 pi by k. Okay, k is also called wave number. Write down time period. What is the time period?
The time taken to come back to the same phase.
Correct. Please write down. Time period is the minimum time. Time period is a minimum time taken by a particle. It is a minimum time taken by a particle to come back to the same phase. Now, can you derive how much will be the time period? It is the derivation exactly same as before. 2 pi by omega?
Yes.
So let's say after time capital T, it will come out to be in the same phase. So A sine kx minus omega T plus capital T plus phi. So this will come out to be A sine kx minus omega T plus phi minus omega capital T. So omega capital T should be
2 pi.
2 pi for it to repeat. So T will be equal to 2 pi by omega. So frequency of the wave will be omega by 2 pi. Okay. So these are some straightforward relations from the wave equation that we have assumed. We have assumed it is sinusoidal. Okay? Any doubts? Anything? So there will be a lot of numericals only on this equation. That will be kinematics of wave.
Sinusoidal wave is any wave that repeats the pattern.
Sinusoidal has a sine shape, sine wave shape.
So if it has like sharp turns.
That is not sinusoidal. That you can say triangular wave.
Sir, can you have an accelerating wave?
Accelerating, yeah, it can be possible. Velocity of the wave depends on the property of medium. If property of medium changes, the wave accelerates. Okay. But at a particular location x, the property of medium will be constant. So velocity at that x will be fixed. Okay.